surrender your vessel, respond.
And if you make any attempt to board or commandeer the Enterprise...
Dear girl, I am a doctor. When I peek, it's in the line of duty.
Oh, my.
We discovered that in order to set things straight again, Edith Keeler must die.
Your orders are to stand by.
I carry them out, Kirkham.
Greetings, fellow Star Trek fans and prop enthusiasts, and thank you for watching this video tutorial on how to build a Star Trek original series communicator kit. The original series communicator is by far one of the most easily recognizable props in TV history. Created by master prop artist Hua-Ming Chang for the Star Trek series in 1966, there were only 10 of these communicators made, with two of the 10 being hero versions with spinning mores. Hua-Ming Chang was a sculptor, artist, as well as a prop maker who was also responsible for many of the props and costumes we've seen over the many years of watching Star Trek, the original series. Before this video begins, please, let me say that this video is not intended to be the final word on how to build one of these communicator kits. This video is primarily aimed at the first-time builder or somebody who's on the fence about purchasing one of these kits, but they don't know quite what to expect. Hopefully, there'll be some first-time builders out there who might find this video useful. So before we get to the build, I just want to shout out a big thank you to the guys over at HeroCom.com. Some of the wonderful photographs you're going to see in this video were donated by that website, and I thank you for it. For those of you who haven't visited this website yet, well, you don't know what you're missing. If you're a fan of the original series communicator or even Star Trek, you've got to visit this website. And to the guys over at the Trek Prop Zone, where there are many wonderful threads on how to build this communicator, where I've received numerous tips and hints on how to do this build. So, let's get started. This build, the first thing we're going to be doing is soldering the wire frame to the antenna, okay? And the tools we're going to need to do this are the liquid flux, the aspirin, the torch, the solder, soldering iron, and helping hand. I finally finished positioning the wire frame to the antenna grill. That took about maybe 10 minutes in real time to do. As you can see, I don't know if you would have been able to see it, but a few of them broke and I had to put new ones in. And you saw that I cut a few of them out because they weren't cooperating. But eventually you'll get it. And you tie them up, you twist them, and you snug them in, not too tight, because you still want to be able to position this if you need to. Okay? And that's it. This looks pretty good. See what happens. Okay, using the liquid flux, we're going to put a small drop right in the corner where I want the solder to go. Okay? Small drop there. Okay, the liquid flux is in that corner. All right? Now, we'll take our soldering iron, okay? And we're going to dip it into that tab of aspirin. Now, you'll notice that as soon as the soldering iron hits the aspirin liquefies on contact. It becomes like water. And it acts as some kind of flux because it really works great. Okay, so we'll dip that around in the aspirin a little bit. Okay? Then we'll take our solder, all right, and we'll put a little on the tip there. Okay? Okay, we got a little solder on there. Fine. Okay. Now we have our electronics torch from Radio Shack. We'll turn it up a little bit. And now we're going to heat the metal up. Now, I know the instructions on the kit say to cut a piece of solder about an inch long and place it in there prior to applying the heat. However, when I tried this, I ran into the problem where the solder would bead up into little balls, as pictured here, okay? This is an example of what not to do when soldering this. The solder will bead up into little balls and it will eventually fall off. All right, now we'll heat the metal up, okay? You don't wanna overheat it, okay? You just leave it there for a good 10 seconds, maybe 10, 15 seconds, just enough for the antenna grill and the wireframe to accept the solder, okay? Now we use our soldering iron and then we'll just dip it right in there. Okay? And guess what? Solder goes right in.